A beautiful look, but a warm start to the week. Temperatures climbing out of the 70s and into the 90s later today. All of central Mississippi this morning stayed mainly in the mid-70s with the exception of the Jackson Metro. Not a lot of wind to make things feel better, so the morning definitely felt muggy, but by the afternoon, it's that typical hot summer day to where it feels like temperatures will well surpass 105, but actual temperatures could get close to 100 degrees, especially for the Jackson Metro. Highs today range between around 95 to 99. Lots of sunshine, very little cloud cover. That is the story for this week. If you're trying to take bets on when we can get the next best chance of rain, don't expect any for the next couple of days. There could be a couple of showers within the next few weeks, but when it comes to the 7-day forecast, just don't get your hopes up. Update on Debbie as of the 7 o'clock advisory. Category 1 storm still made landfall just after 6 a.m. over towards Steinhatchee, Florida. The eye wall continuing to barrel down just towards north of Cross City. But this is the big outlook of Debbie. The outer bands continuing to cause issues from Orlando to Kissimmee down towards Sarasota. And there's been tornado warnings as well around this area over the past couple of hours. The big concern with this storm is going to be the flooding and the rainfall. There's already been several flash flood warnings from Ben Venice Beach all the way to Valdosta, Georgia, and that's only going to continue to move closer inland as this storm slows down and moves into Georgia and South Carolina. There's that view of the eye wall from Perry to Branford. The eye itself now officially onto land, and I do expect it to downgrade to a tropical storm later today. I know this is a lot of colors, but I want to show you just how far inland and far north these watches and warnings go. Tropical storm watch from Statesboro, Georgia, down towards Albany, from Buford over towards Charleston, South Carolina. Tropical storm warnings, and that could possibly get extended into Myrtle Beach and Wilmington, North Carolina within the coming days. This storm is something to be talked about for the next several days, not just because of the rainfall, but because of how slow it's going to be moving. The past 24 hours, 5 to even a foot of rain being measured along the west coast of Florida, and more is on the way from Jacksonville all the way up to Wilmington, North Carolina. Some places getting anywhere between 10 to 20 inches of rainfall by the end of the week. Historic flooding looking likely for Charleston and Savannah, Georgia. The benefits of this storm, if you can really say there's any benefits, is the fact that we'll get some drier air on the western side that heads our way for much of this week. So real feel values will still surpass 105, but it definitely could be a lot worse. Tonight, we're back into the mid to upper 70s. We'll get introduced 100 degrees for a couple of areas going into tomorrow, and more places looking likely hitting and surpassing 100 Wednesday and Thursday. Jackson getting close to the 1947 record of 102 by Wednesday afternoon. Week boundary moves through by the end of the week, and that could drop temperatures and dew points by the weekend.